Welcome back to Math 103. This is video number 4 on growth and finance. If Rutgers tuition increases by 4% every year from a starting point of $10,954, by what overall percentage will it have increased after 2 years? So there are two ways of looking at this. We can either successively compute the new tuition 1 year at a time, and then compare the tuition after 2 years to the original tuition, or we can compute a single number, a single growth factor, to summarize the effect of 2 years of 4% annual growth all at once. That is an overall 2 year growth factor. Let's look at the first viewpoint. We compute tuition 1 year at a time and compare the tuition after 2 years to the original tuition. So the tuition after 1 year of growth is current tuition times 1.04. So the $10,954 times the growth factor, 1.04. And that is a number we computed earlier, $11,392.16. Great. So what's the tuition after 2 years? So it's this tuition, the tuition after 1 year, the 2015 tuition, times another copy of the growth factor. So it's this $11,392.16, the result of a single growth, now experiences another 4% growth. So that number going into the 2016 school year has to get multiplied by 1.04 to find out that new tuition in 2016. That's $11,847.85. So with each successive year, we multiply by a new copy of 1.04. Great, so after two growths, we have a new tuition of $11,847.85. How much more is that? How many times greater is that than the original tuition? It's 1.0816 times greater. In other words, the new tuition can be written as 1.0816 times the original tuition, right? If you multiplied both sides right here by $10,954, you would have $11,847.85 equals the old tuition, $10,954, times this factor 1.0816. Well, what does that tell us? It means that the new tuition is the result of multiplying the original tuition by 1.0816. In other words, the overall 2 year growth factor is 1.0816. Right? Multiplying by this number captures 2 years worth of growth. So we've found a 2 year growth factor. What does this 2 year growth factor, 1.0816, tell us about the overall percentage increase? Well, by the same thinking we used at the beginning of this topic, new tuition equals original tuition times growth factor. That is to say, original tuition, one copy of original tuition, plus 0.0816 copies of the original tuition. So the tuition will have had an overall increase of 8.16%. What did I just do? I took the decimal form of 0.0816 and I converted it to the percent form. Right, we do our computations in decimal form, but we are often asked at the end to express answers in percent form. So I just did that conversion. Every growth factor should be thought of as 1 plus something. The 1 represents one copy of the original quantity, and this something here after the plus represents the new growth. Thus, what we've just done is, in effect, to take the growth factor 1.0816, we've subtracted the 1 from it to obtain the new growth part, just the 0.0816. And we've converted that 0.0816 from decimal to percent form. Great, so we carried out the first viewpoint. Now, what's the second viewpoint? We can say that the tuition after two successive 4% increases equals the original amount times 1.04, in parentheses here, times another copy of 1.04. So whatever's inside these parentheses here equals the tuition after one growth has occurred. And then that number, however much it turns out to be, is multiplied by another copy of 1.04 to reflect the second year's growth. These parentheses are telling me to do this multiplication first, and whatever I get, I then multiply by 1.04. But thanks to the associative property of multiplication, I'm also allowed to move these parentheses and carry out this multiplication, see what I get, and multiply that by 10,954. That is legal on all seven continents, and it makes a real difference to our understanding of the mathematics of growth. Because we can compute 1.04 times 1.04, that's 1.04 squared, that's 1.0816. We can compute whatever's in here first, and that is our growth factor. Okay, whatever is the outcome of this computation inside these parentheses, that'll just be one big number that multiplies the 10,954. In other words, that is the growth factor. So we come to the same conclusion as in the first viewpoint, that 1.0816 is the two-year growth factor. This one number summarizes 2 years of growth. No matter which viewpoint we use, we must understand a truly crucial point, and that is to find the effect of successive percentage growths, first by 4% and then by another 4%, we absolutely do not add 4% plus 4%. We do not add percentages. We multiply growth factors. That is absolutely crucial. If we add 4% to another 4%, we'll get 8%, and that would be wrong. Another remark here, and this is important, is that to compute the 2 years of 4% growth are equivalent to an overall 8.16% growth, we don't actually need to know the original tuition. We discover this growth factor of 1.0816 just by computing the product of the separate one-year growth factors. So we have 1 year of getting multiplied by 1.04, followed by another year of getting multiplied by 1.04. So the overall effect of these successive growths is to get multiplied once by 1.0816. In other words, to grow by 8.16% overall. To reach this conclusion, we didn't actually need to know what the original tuition was. We just need to know how much each growth is and how many growths there are. This is really very useful to be able to work just with the growth factors and without the dollar amounts. Well, what about more than 2 years? Before going on to the next video, think about and try to answer the following questions. By what overall percentage will the tuition have increased after 3 years of these 4% increases? After 18 years of 4% annual increases, or after 30 years of 4% annual increases? I claim that the thought process is fundamentally the same as what we just did for 2 years of growth.